Hi guys! Jake and Marissa back again for more Uchi Sentai Kyuranger!
And for the first time in 2 weeks, we're not time traveling!
Yeah. I mean, there's like a bunch of stuff that I'm still working on that's going to be released before this.
Yeah, but none of it's going to be released after this, so we're not time traveling.
This is true.
We have not filmed something before now that will be released after now.
That is true.
Aside from, of course, DRPR 79 and 80, but...
Yeah, that's still in the works. Right now, I'm focusing on getting out all the videos of the...
Right, and then you'll go back
trip,
to 79.
Which are hopefully all out now. So yes, that's why this week, Kyuranger Live Reactions is being released a bit late. I wanted to focus on making sure to get all those... videos of the LA premiere trip out first, so that took up the week, and
we'll get caught up because there's plenty of time.
Yeah, so basically the plan is, obviously this one's being released on Sunday night instead of the usual Wednesday night. We'll do episode 7. We'll record right now. I just got back yesterday, so this is getting released, so this is recorded a week before they're seeing it.
Yes. It's Sunday,
it's
the 26th.
So this will be released next Sunday. Next Sunday we'll record, when I get back from my trip to Florida, then we'll record episode 7.
Which will come out on...
That'll come out on Wednesday. And
then we'll film one on Saturday that comes out on Sunday, and stick with that
until Power Rangers
comes back.
Yeah, so we're sort of juggling things around so that Kyuranger will be taking the Sunday night slot.
So you just had a week
Rangers.
Of individual small videos.
Yes.
Now you have today.
Yes.
Then you'll have Wednesday, then next Sunday, and subsequent to that, Sundays only.
Yes.
Until Power Rangers comes back, or we get out of DRPR.
Yes. Which... I was hoping to get it out during spring break,
and then
I got two trips that happened.
Yeah, but even if you had all the even if you did that, you still wouldn't have all the footage we need for 79.
Yeah, I know. I'm still working on that. But also, the fact that I have two trips severely limited my availability for filming as well.
Yeah, your parents chose an interesting time to move, but...
It
is also probably the only time you'd be able to help
them, because... Unless they were moving over the summer, yeah.
Right.
Who wants to move to Florida during the summer?
No one?
Yeah. Anyway, so at this point, you guys already know our thoughts on the Power Rangers movie and how crazy awesome it was.
And how we didn't put enough tape on the thing. We had to stop.
I recorded so
much. We really thought
that
was going to be a much shorter conversation.
We're
like, we got 20 minutes. We can do this.
Yeah. We tried to keep it quick. And then, you had a bunch of tangents, and I had too many things I wanted to cover.
Yeah. Well, I didn't know mine were tangents, because I didn't know we were on a track. You didn't tell me about the track.
Well, we would be talking about one thing, and then all of a sudden it's like, oh, and teleportation! I'm like, I thought we were just talking about power coins. I thought we were just talking about actors a moment ago, and then all of a sudden we're on teleportation.
We were just having a fluid conversation.
Anyway.
Anyways, we
won't talk about that.
We ran out of tape twice.
Yeah.
You had fun. And this time we have enough tape on the thing that we should be fine.
Yeah, we should be good. Right.
We haven't run out during live reaction in a while, because we clear out plenty of space for these.
Yeah, I didn't clear out as much as I would have liked, because I'm still, editing stuff.
And compiling stuff from the trip.
For the,
so I guess we should stop wasting time talking about losing tape.
Yes.
While we're running tape, and start the episode.
Yes. So let's do that. So now, let's see here. Time for episode 6 of Uchi Sentai Kyuranger. What's the name of this episode? It is Flap Your Wings, Dancing Star. Don't know what that means, but we will find out.
We will find out.
That magical sound.
I love that sound.
Hey, is that Annie?
Yeah, and she's narrating.
Nice. Stinger joined the team. Now all nine are gathered. Beautiful.
And then we'll go on to liberate the universe. See, Malastrates. I'm so confused because that's what it says in the subtitle, but that's not quite what they say.
They say a lot of things.
Yeah.
All
the Ramune. Okay, someone likes Ramune. But you know what's funny about
that? Oh, they're liberating a specific district today.
Is the whole business with the,
Okay, so different districts have Malastrates.
What do you call it? The Zords.
Yeah.
The balls in them. They look kind of like the marbles in a Ramune bubble.
Right. Nice. Oh, wow.
Wow.
Oh, wow. She nominates herself. What? Ooh.
Oh.
Hey, she has seniority over you, dude. He is so confused.
Everyone's nominating themselves. Everyone.
Wow, it was a spheretastic idea. Okay.
We're gonna make it competitive? That's not a good idea.
No.
It's never a good idea to make a team-based...
Cue Letter Chance! This is so ridiculous. Tama, Q.
Where do you get a stage?
It's just the lighting changes, I think. Hey. We got balance.
Wait a minute, does that mean that the rest of them aren't even in the running?
I guess.
He said whoever accomplishes the most of the next mission. They only sent 5 of them. That means the rest of them aren't even eligible. Are these people doing a marathon or what?
No, they are being forced to dance for music, I guess. Oh, never mind. They were trying to dance.
Instead of do their calisthenics.
Oi. Denville Calisthenics. Wow, this is pretty awful.
That kind of looks like a dance, too.
Yeah, but only his dance can be done. They're all fighting over who gets to fight this Malastrate. Okay, so the Malastrates are basically, like, governors. They're the monsters of the week. They're also the governors of specific districts.
Yes.
Whereas, Aerodron was a Menester.
Which is the whole planet.
He was a galaxy-wide.
Oh, galaxy?
I thought it was
the Saturn system. That's
no, Sagittarius system.
Okay. I thought the system was a star system, not a galaxy.
Okay, maybe in that case a
solar system.
Maybe in that case a star system.
Yeah.
A star system and solar system would be two different things.
Wait, what?
Really?
She put it in the pool hall ball table, and it came out in his belt.
That is an interesting way.
So I guess now we know why they have a pool table.
I guess. Ooh. Pegasus Kyutama. That's interesting. Mr. Pega? Wait, you're a character? Oh, here it goes.
Ew. Hang on.
9 ultimate saviors will save you.
Hey!
Oh, sorry. There it goes.
The cord is shorter than you think.
Sorry. Kimi ga kira hekuru mirai mitai na ninda. Good luck. We're gonna like
we're gonna get that eventually.
We're gonna just keep getting better, I think, each week. This will be a slow evolution.
Yeah, it will.
Follow along with us.
And I do apologize for that one person who commented that we should just stop singing.
Yeah.
That's not gonna happen.
We're gonna keep trying. Cheer Rangers won't give up, and neither shall we. Even though we don't speak Japanese.
If I actually took the time to practice, I could do it. There are so many songs I already know in Japanese. I have so much more to do.
Yeah.
Plus, has way more long words in it than any other Japanese song I've learned.
That's why I really gotta just go through the lyrics and like break them apart more into phonetics as opposed to the actual words, so that.
I gotta look at them and figure out the compound words that they're made of, because I can see.
Yeah.
Words I know how to pronounce.
Pega, Mr. Pega, just sort of takes.
And thank you to the two people who told me that Mirai is the future.
Oh my. They're all in each other's way. No chance of victory. Oh my.
Wait a minute. Did the people who... Yeah, I was gonna say, the people who do the calisthenics, are they training to become Tron people?
I'm not sure. No. They're running interference. They're trained to act as human shields. They're basically forced to act as human shields.
Mate. That means wait.
Mr. Pega is very bossy.
They are actually...
Black
Ranger
heads.
Be more, you know, into that than they are?
Mr. Pega's still there. This is interesting.
Okay, but that still doesn't explain why Mr. Pega is an outfit.
I think he's getting there. He's telling his journey through the Pegasus system.
This is something you see a lot in Japanese media, where someone tells a story with a bunch of cards.
Interesting. So apparently Mr. Pega joined forces with Xiaolongbo. And
That's gotta come from some form of like thing that gets done in school or something.
I like how Naga just walked up to the camera and said, "I'm sure this is a lie." Really? They are not very team-like right now.
No. Well, that's what he gets for making it a competition.
Yeah.
You should not... Like, if you have a basketball team and you decide to compete over who's going to score the most baskets...
Yeah,
people are going to end up hogging the ball. It's going to be terrible. That's exactly what's going on here.
Hey, Stinger!
Dance practice?
Yay. I'm like Stingers. Stingers does. Ain't no Stingers got time for that.
QQ Tama Tama?
QQ Ninja. Oh wow, they are really doing the dance.
Mr. Pega, could you
sit
down?
Why is Mr. Pega, like, not. Mr. Wow, what are you doing, Naga?
Breakdancing.
And.
Okay, wait a minute.
Are we gonna get Little Dreams
No.
throughout this series?
This is both of you dance like you want to win.
Yeah.
That episode of Neon Genesis Evangelion where Shinji and Asuka had to get synced up?
Yeah, exactly. That's what they're doing.
This is both of you dance like you want to win.
Like, Geki Ranger had one of those too.
Now I'm unsure.
Oh, hello. We've got a few more big bats here. Who are these guys?
Both of you dance like you want to win.
Well, I know the episode you're talking about.
Yeah, that is.
So we got Ika again, and so Ika again and Mute again.
It's the second title of that episode. I was uncertain
okay,
myself.
Okay, Ika again and Madako are looking
makes
for the
it, Oh! He just insulted the squid.
Yep.
No use getting all inked up.
Interesting.
What
are you doing, Pega?
Wrecking the room. Hold your horses, Lucky! Hammy, that's not a good attitude.
Yeah, you are a mess, Pega. Like, you are a huge pain in the neck.
Pega, you are not showing much assistance at the moment.
Yeah. You, like, just be an
impediment. You are an impediment at the moment.
Like.
What?
Yeah. He's luring them out to a fight.
Alone?
I don't know, that's how he likes to function.
Yeah, but it's 2-on-1, not 1-on-1.
Yeah.
This concerns me.
I'm curious how this will go.
Not well.
Probably not.
I guess this is how he needs to learn his teamwork lesson, is because he decides to go out and fight on his own, while the rest of them apparently cannot dance together or cooperate.
Oh, they're assassins.
Both of you dance like you want to win!
Interesting.
Not very good assassins.
Well, they're dodging him pretty well. Which
but
would suggest
shouldn't an
they're
assassin
skilled.
Not be discovered before they try to kill you?
Fair enough. I don't know if that's as, if that's as common a trope in Japan.
Yeah.
I think
with a lot of the people who are just, like, going about their daily life and then somebody blows their brains out and that's an assassination.
Yes. But I think,
With no preamble. They are gonna be tough to deal with. Maybe you should have brought your friends!
Yeah. Well, going off of, other, assassins I've seen in, like, Japanese media, like anime, it's a little bit less of a covert assassination and more, almost more of a bounty hunter type of thing, where it's like, I've been paid to kill you now, so I'm gonna kill you now.
A little bit like, the Narn Assassin's Guild. You shall
all he has is his good
you
luck.
You shall know pain, and you shall die.
Ooh, backstory. She's Inobi. Daughter of Shinobi. She's trained very hard, apparently. What's a shinobi?
Yeah.
It's a ninja, basically.
Look, we have all been a little irritated by Lucky doing only luck.
Interesting.
Do we have the wrong idea about Lucky?
It's not just his luck. It's the thing.
He's also the heart of the team. Some BS
well, yeah.
Like that. He's been practicing.
He has the best luck, but he also does work hard.
Training. He's training.
Interesting.
Huh. Optimism. It's not just luck, it's optimism.
Yeah.
Though, to be fair, it's very easy to be optimistic when you have the most luck in the universe.
Yeah, it's sort of a positive feedback loop there.
Yeah.
He kind of draws the luck to him with his optimism, and then the luck gives him more optimism. Oh, my,
why does he have a punching bag?
It, this appears to be their training gym. I think that might be on the ship.
No, I mean, Balance was actually carrying it in one arm while they were dancing.
Oh, I missed that. That's weird.
I was very confused.
These groups of five are very interesting.
Says a change! Stop changing!
Yep. Mr. Pega has been a very weird addition this episode.
Well, I think Mr. Pega's about to start being more useful because of all the training that was done.
Basically, I certainly hope so.
Lucky has perhaps subdued his bizarre nature.
Yeah.
So apparently there's like a like lesson of the week that I need to watch that involves the Yellow Ranger potentially putting someone's eye out.
Yeah, it's something about how their morphs all work. I still need to see that as well as supplementary videos.
Yeah, we gotta see that. Uh-oh.
They have coordination.
They do have coordination.
Alright, so let's see if the Q-Tama dance will make this work. This is going to be so weird. They are actually doing the dance in battle, because of course they are.
Wasn't there another Sentai that had this problem?
Gekyo Ranger. It was, and that got translated to Jungle Fury.
Yeah.
Dance the Night Away, episode 6, I believe. I feel like this is a recurring trope. Seeing as how it...
Well, they do like to put the song and dance in the closing credits of every Sentai.
Naga, why do you keep talking to the camera?
Because Naga knows about the fourth wall.
Apparently.
Which is yet another reason I love Naga. Before the blue parts of those of the weapons, the bright blue parts.
Yeah, they're starfields.
Glittery.
Yep.
I mean, I knew that the black parts, the navy blue, dark blue, black parts were starfields, but apparently so is the blue parts of the weapons.
Yep.
I did not notice that before just now.
Yep.
Now someone in the comments is gonna go, Marissa, you really didn't notice that?
Nah.
Yeah, I really didn't notice that. No, just like. If I say I didn't notice something, I really didn't notice it. Sorry.
Yep. You got...
You were, in fact, out-coordinated.
Yeah, out-coordinated. And that whole dance sequence really only worked because...
Next is the Consumeras. Also, the Consumeras is the big.
Oh, is that what those
are? Apparently.
Is that what that...
That's what that is.
Oh, okay. So this
that's
the Consumar. Okay.
Which for some reason has a Z on it in the subtitle.
Yeah. Hey. I feel like we're going to get a different combination every single episode.
We are.
Because
the only thing that's going to maintain consistency is that Lucky is the hub.
Well, unless we get a secondary hub, which is entirely possible.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
Nice.
That is interesting that we're going to have... Just the thought of having a different combination every single episode is pretty unusual.
Yeah. I want to know how they're going to make this work in toys.
I mean, how so?
The part where it could be either an arm or a leg.
I mean, the docking points are the same.
Fair enough.
That's how it works in the toys.
I feel like the knee joint's a little bit different, but maybe I'm wrong.
No, it's the same sort of attachment points.
These group activities are hard to do.
Yep.
I really need to clean my desk. I can see it in the video. It's a mess.
Oh, sorry, Ann.
That's okay. I'll clean it this week while you're gone.
Yeah, they're all jelly brains. Hmm. These two are interesting and random. What?
You're stuck wearing a dead Pegasus for the rest of your life? Okay. He's just sleeping. Oh, good. Lucky finally gets to stop wearing a Pegasus. He's gonna go back to being a Q-tama.
This was a very strange upgrade, armor thing. What? What's happening now?
Fully demographic. Democratic.
I guess so.
Huh. I mean, you do have the commander, so there's always that. I just found popcorn in my teeth from last night.
Mm.
I hate how deep popcorn can get lodged.
Mm.
But I did eat
and
a lot.
Here comes the dance.
What we're gonna do?
Lucky Ranger. Lucky Ranger. Do li 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 li. Oh, cute, Q, dama, 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 Q, Q, dupadi, bada, badu, mahadi. Q, Q, dama, 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 Q, Q, dupadi, bada, bada, badi, badu. Q, Q, dama, 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 Q, Q, dupadi, badi, bada, bu, badi, badu. Into one, oh, Q, up, boom. Q, Q, dama, 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 Q, Q, dupadi, badi, bada, bada. So, hey, Balance, you getting a focus? Wait.
They took my birthday.
So, wait,
hey,
X-Aid?
It's that thing that's in the interstitials.
X-Aid is showing up? That's random.
Is that the pink-haired thing?
Yeah. We're getting X-Aid team up next episode?
Apparently so.
Say what? That's not expected. Serious. Oh, it's one of the crazy Sentai Kamen Rider movie team ups coming up. That's the other thing.
Saturday Roadshow?
Super Superhero Wars.
Super Superhero Wars.
Yes. Huh. So apparently we're getting a Kamen Rider team up next episode. That's unexpected.
Wait, that pink thing is a Kamen Rider?
Yeah, that's Kamen Rider X-Aid.
It doesn't even look like a person.
I know. It's really weird. Well, I mean, no, it still looks like a person. It's just a person in armor with pink hair.
A chunky square person in armor.
Well, there was another thing, too, that was not person-shaped. So much. The like chibi thing, I don't know what it is.
That's what I was talking about.
No, there was also one that was actually like warrior shaped.
Oh, okay. I just saw the chibi looking one that looked an awful lot like the wind up toy that you see in the end.
Yeah, well, no, the wind up toy is. I know it's hard to tell, but it's for someone who's the same shape as the Q Ranger is for me.
Obviously, yeah. But.
That yeah, there's chibi also that thing. Chibi thing. I do not know enough about X-Aid
to
really
know what that chibi thing is.
I do not. I have not been following X-Aid.
I feel like we didn't get as much hammy backstory as I would have liked. All she really said was, I came from a shinobi family.
Yeah.
And I trained really hard.
Yeah.
I was like, okay.
It's just like, I worked really hard.
I worked really hard to get here. Great.
I'd like a little bit more on you, hammy, there.
Got any brothers, sisters? Dirty Secrets, Dead Boyfriends.
Like, the weird thing about Hammy in this episode is that her whole thing this episode seemed to be that,
she doesn't play well with others?
Well, more so that she takes everything super seriously and doesn't think that the others take things as seriously. Which is super weird, because what's been her primary character trait up until this point?
Being the giggly one?
Yeah, she's the one who finds everything hilarious.
Yeah.
That doesn't make any sense. This has been probably the weakest episode so far.
There was a cat behind me. It's not there anymore. And yes.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what we get for Hammy.
Yeah. I'm hoping we get something more in the future, but that was...
Hammy girl, you let me down.
Well, on top of everything...
You're letting me down.
Well, on top of everything else, you know, as, once again, Lucky kind of took center stage again. In this case, literally, in terms of the dance.
He's always going to take center stage.
Yeah.
It happens a lot with Red Rangers.
Yeah.
Or Red Sentais.
Because this was all about...
Red Rangers.
It felt like Mr. Pega was basically just a huge distraction this episode.
He was cheap comic relief.
He didn't factor into the main plot about teamwork.
Nope.
He really just...
Cheap comic relief and a toy. Yeah. I'm sure there's a toy.
Oh yeah, of course.
Cheap comic relief and a toy. That's what Mr. Pega is.
Like, it, you know, the whole thing was about teamwork, etc., and
then there's Mr. Pega.
And Mr. Pega was just, like, flying all over the place, just dragging Lucky around for the ride, and I don't really know why.
And apparently, being dragged around by Mr. Pega meant that Lucky was contributing the most to the fight.
Yeah, that didn't make any sense.
If anything, Mr. Pega was doing that, because Lucky was basically not in control of a lot of what he was doing at that point.
Yeah, this...
He was getting pulled around like a rag doll.
This episode, definitely, like, I feel like Mr. Pega really brought it down, actually. I mean, he would have been fine, I think, in a different episode, but
maybe.
He just did not work with this with the main plot. About,
I mean, his physical design is nice, but...
Yeah. Well, I mean, even his design is, like, okay, but, like... In a show where everything else is, like, really nice looking as far as the Q-Ranger designs,
mm-hmm.
He's a little underwhelming. He's just a big head on the chest with wings
he's
that are
sparkly.
Kind of... He is.
I like sparkly.
I didn't like how they were... I understand functionally speaking...
There's something weird about
that.
His nose, though. He has some patches on it that don't sparkle.
And there were like, little creases in the wings that I recognized was because of the... Was so that they could, you know, fold when... for stunts, but it still just didn't look very good with the Starfield on it. I liked the random backstory of Mr. Pega and Commander
Longbow.
That
was Longbow.
Cute. That
was
cute.
That bit with the cards.
Yeah.
I've seen that in, like, a bunch of other anime, too.
Yeah.
Like, where someone's telling a story and they do it with the cards. That's gotta be something common that they do in, like, school when they're telling stories or something. You know?
Yeah, I think that might also be some sort of traditional, means of street theater as well, actually.
Entirely
possible. I forget the term, but I think I've heard of some form of Japanese street theater where, basically you narrate a story while, showing different, portraits of the story.
What are you doing?
Japanese storytelling with picture cards.
Kanbashi.
Kanbashi.
A paper play.
Yeah, that's it.
A narrator.
Kamishibai. Mm. Kamishibai.
You travel to street corners with sets of illustrated boards placed on a miniature stage and narrated the story by changing each image.
Yeah.
So that's
Kamishibai.
Kamishibai.
All right, good.
I could
pronounce that.
I just recognize that as a trope that I see a lot in
yeah.
And I was like, oh,
I think this again. I think one of the initial, like...
I think my favorite example of that one is the one in Risky Safety.
Yeah. I think one of the earliest, like, Henshin heroes was through Kamishibai.
It wouldn't surprise me.
Hey, Ollie. How you doing?
I mean, it does seem like a good medium to, you know, predate television.
Yeah.
Like, different pictures.
But yeah, so... We are starting to understand a little bit better the terminology dealing with shark matter. We've been having trouble following that.
We've figured out, I think, a general idea of the terminologies and how they apply to different monsters.
Yeah.
We've got the regional monsters, the star system monsters, and their wacky robots that turn inside out and become giant monsters.
Yeah.
Which are consumars.
Yes. Now I know why they were saying they're... Oh, we've never seen so many consumars on a single planet. Okay, that's referring to the ships, which I think is just something we missed. We missed earlier what the ships were called. It's hard to keep track of these things, unfortunately. And then the Menesters are for star systems. Malestrates are generally for individual planets, but
looks like Earth has got one for each district.
Yes. Usually a district would be an entire planet. Earth has many districts.
Probably because it has so much planetarium. Or Ramune!
Planetium.
Ramune!
And there's probably something else going on with Earth as well.
I should pick up Ramune for our next review.
Yeah.
We could sit here and drink Ramune while we review.
That'd be amusing.
I can do that.
But I mean,
I haven't been to Asian grocery in a while, anyway.
Mm. Well, one thing that,
Rada Kamabashi.
That this, did kind of solidify a little bit more from the first episode is that, Hemi apparently did...
And Tofu.
She thought of herself as the leader, originally, I think.
I think she did, too, out of the three that there were there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I don't think the other two
ever thought that way, no.
Yeah.
No, I don't think they did. Actually, the way it seemed to me when they first got there was, it seemed to me like Raptor was the leader.
Sorry, she was mission control.
She's definitely the one who is coordinating everything, so it seemed like that to me.
Raptor's little imagination bubbles continue to be adorable.
They are adorable.
It's like, me? The leader? And then her imagining herself as a pop idol as well. Raptor's kind of the best.
That is a real workout for your upper arms.
Yeah.
I don't know about you, but it is for me.
I'm
not in shape.
Well, also, like, I feel like I already got a workout for my upper arms by having to lug suitcases back and forth all over airports twice during 2 days this past week.
Have you told that story yet?
I don't need to.
there was a lot more running than there was supposed to be because
there was a lot of running around due to gates moving around.
Yeah,
and I had to move very quickly
while carrying my luggage,
and that was quite the workout there. I'm honestly surprised that I didn't just like pass out somewhere along the line there.
Probably in Chicago.
Yeah. I was fully, like, I'm running along, I'm like, it's like ninth grade gym class and being asked to run a mile. This is not going well for me.
You only had to run the mile in ninth grade?
I'm just picking a random year.
We had to run the mile, like,
every year. I had to do it in middle school, too.
No, and every year of high school.
I forget if it was every year. I don't know.
Not just every year, just every gym class.
Every gym class? You had to run the mile?
Well,
that's like half a gym class.
When it was the season where you could go outside, because they didn't make us do it indoors.
That's a lot of running.
Yeah, I hated it. Oh, except during the archery unit. We all loved the archery unit because we never had to change.
So you
could do the archery unit in your actual clothes.
So yeah.
And in the winter, one thing we did get to do instead of running the miles cross-country skiing.
Okay.
We did a lot of running.
Yeah, it sounds like it.
A lot of running. But to be perfectly honest, most of us in the girls' class wound up walking.
Yeah, exactly. I don't remember, I mean, I don't remember gym class that well, but I don't remember there being nearly that much running. I remember there being more, like, sports and stuff.
Well, the whole winter, there was, like, a lot of stuff indoors in the gymnasium, but outside, yeah. It was pretty much all running.
Yeah.
Or cross-country, or archery. But archery only lasted for, like, 3 weeks, but everybody loved archery because you didn't have to change.
Yeah. Archery was interesting.
Oh, we didn't let the boys do archery.
No?
No. The boys had baseball while the girls had archery. I guess the school had decided something like 10 years earlier that you couldn't trust boys with weapons of any kind.
That's fair. I think there was a little bit of archery back in high school. Just not much of it.
Yeah, I was actually somewhat good with the 30-pound recurve bow.
Nice. So yeah, this one was
badminton were my sports.
This one was problem was now we've finished up the intro arc. It looks like we're getting a little bit more into filler stuff at the moment. Although we did get to meet the two new assassins,
who both appear to have a squid motif going on.
Yeah, or some sort of
don't ink yourself. One of them said to the other one.
Cephalopod kind of thing going on. Maybe one's a squid, one's an octopus. I'm not sure. Oh wait, well one was. What were their two names again? Because one I think was like Ikago, and isn't Ika squid?
Ika's a squid.
And the other one was like Muga something.
I don't know. Octopus is taco, or at least octopus is taco at the sushi restaurant.
Fair enough.
It could be like pig and pork though, so I don't know.
I'm trying to look up their names.
Taco could just be octopus meat, but. I like taco sashimi, and I like takoyaki, and I just like taco.
Right.
And I like tacos. But I don't like burritos.
I'll figure out their names. But yeah, they seem to be the new arc villains. Which is different from what I was
expecting.
They're
giving me shades of Fear Cats, though.
Yeah?
Yeah.
In what way, apart from just being two monsters that work together?
They're not. They seem to have an antagonistic relationship as partners.
Yeah.
That looks like it's going to bite them in the butt.
Just a little.
What are you getting into over there?
I don't know. Frankie, come on. Leave the recyclables alone.
Oh, it's just the recyclables. I don't care then.
As long as he's not getting into
the cabinet with all the cat.
The Fear Cats weren't that antagonistic. Yeah. Frankie, stop that. Stop. Now, the Fear Cats weren't that antagonistic to each other. They seemed to work together, actually, pretty well.
Oh, well, that goes to show how good my memory of Operation Overdrive is.
Yeah. I mean, they were antagonistic
worst
to everyone
Power
else.
Worst Rangers ever.
Yeah. Yeah.
Somebody spelled it really weird in the comments.
House.
They spelled it RPM. Yeah. That's not how you spell Operation Overdrive.
But yeah, this episode was kind of. I'm curious to see.
Like, I don't even have much to say about this.
Yeah.
It's just.
I mean, it was cute seeing the dance in motion. That was a nice little bit of choreography.
Yeah, we got the dance in the story.
Yeah.
That was cool. That was cute. I really was expecting more of a dance. Both of you dance like you want to win plotline, but nobody came back to successfully practice, and then they managed to do it in
battle. Well, they did at the end. They came back to practice at the end.
After the battle?
No, well, not after the battle, but right before the battle. After you saw...
I said successfully practice. They still look like a hot mess at that point.
No, they were pretty well in sync. Because after Lucky went through the night on it...
Well, Lucky definitely spent a lot of time...
And then afterwards you saw the quick little time lapse of everybody else joining.
I was going to say, I think the time lapse jumps may have...
Yeah, there was a quick time lapse of everybody else joining in, and they all joined in sync. They were doing it in sync during that bit. And keep in mind that... Keep in mind that only five of them need to really learn it.
That's true.
Like...
And I don't know why Balance had a bag in his arm for some reason.
I don't know.
I'm not sure it was a punching bag. It was, like, maybe it was a thief bag? I don't know. It was big and white, and I was confused.
Yeah.
Or maybe I'll go back and look at it later and go, that's not a big white bag. What was I thinking?
Yeah.
Because it was very quick.
But we are seeing some of the problems of such a large cast right now in terms of balancing plot lines.
Yeah.
When
you have this big a cast, it can be difficult to get everybody enough time to develop their character on screen.
Yeah.
Screen time. Screen time is at a premium when you have 9 main characters.
Like, so far, I think the best have been, like, episode 3 and episode 4.
I'm bad with numbers.
That was the intro for Stinger and the intro for Washi Pink. Yeah, that was the best episode, but that also didn't have Stinger in it. But it did manage to keep a pretty tight focus on Raptor and had everybody else be servicing Raptor's story in their own unique ways.
And Lucky had a dream that was so big that he made the monster explode.
Well, that was the next episode, episode 5.
That's what I said, and then.
Yeah.
That was good too. I like that one also.
So it seems like they're currently at their best when they have
Oh no, wait, that was the one before that, wasn't it?
When they have a tighter focus and find ways to use the other characters to serve that.
You know, interestingly, that's similar problems to what's going on with the...
Industrial?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Scattered storytelling, not focusing enough in a given story, having a B-plot that doesn't need to be there and doesn't help.
Ninja Steel also doesn't really even have much by way of B-plots.
Well, in their case, it would be the completely disjointed adventures of the Farting Brothers.
Yeah, fair enough. Ninja Steel has its own set of problems.
Weirdness. Like Mr. Pegasus!
Yeah, Mr. Pega, you just... You.
Why?
That, honestly, why? I would much rather that they just had focused on the core of... You have the story with Hammy, her resentment of Lucky, her rivalry with Garu, and then maybe a little bit of... And then instead of throwing in Mr. Pega in here, you know, just have on the sidelines, okay, a little bit of Spada and Champ being supportive of Hammy because they were with her the longest, or...
That'd be good.
Or Naga and Balance just having a running gag of them being clueless about the whole thing.
Naga's... Naga didn't try to identify any emotions, did he?
No, he was just sort of odd and talking to the camera today. Although, at the very least, one thing that they are doing pretty good with Naga is continually having him present the wrong emotions for whatever he's trying to do.
Yeah. I like Naga.
I should be. He had, like, a terrified look on his face when he said it.
I know, but I just love Naga.
Yeah. I wasn't as on board with Naga in his initial introduction, but the more I see of him, the more I like him.
Yeah, it's not that he's, like, completely stoic, no emotion dude. It's that he's got some sort of... He is a good analogy for certain types of neurovariants where you're not really sure how you're supposed to present various emotions.
Yeah.
Which
is kind of great.
Covers several different types of neurovariants.
Yeah, exactly.
Including personality disorders and autism spectrum and just alexithymia in general. And a lot of different things you could map onto that. Yeah. And he's fun like that.
But,
and he has the creepy eyeballs!
But I mean, we had
creepy eyeballs.
We had a side plot with Stinger. That worked fine. That was just sort of introducing what will be our running subplot, and I think that was a good way to introduce it.
You know what else was covered in creepy eyeballs besides Full Metal Alchemist with the gate?
Hi, guy.
No, I was thinking about Great Big Space Ray when she got covered in eyeballs and then kind of like thing, and then there was one in her forehead, and then
Yeah, yeah.
That was creepy, too.
But, yeah, you see how like, this episode could have been such a better character episode without Mr. Pega.
Because Mr. Pega was a major impediment.
And, like, I liked other things where it was, if it had been an episode about that, that would have been fine, and you could have found your own way to make that work. But
it wasn't an episode about that, and he wasn't contributing anything, and Mr. Pega can bite me.
Yeah, his
he's pretty.
The fact that he didn't fit right in the story really kind of made me dislike him. He might have been more fun if it wasn't for the fact that he took away from the story of this episode.
Yeah.
And I do also feel like it is kind of early to be having.
I'm not sure if he took away from the story of this episode, or if he was used as a band-aid to bandage the fact that this episode had pretty much nothing to work with, because they haven't decided what Hammy's actually like. They're just like, oh, she's in Vermin Ninja Family, and this is supposed to be her backstory episode, but this is all the backstory we have, and we need to fill this much episode, so let's just throw in a hyperactive Pegasus for the rest of it.
I don't know.
Either way, it's a cheap shot.
Yeah. Poor Hammy. You need some more backstory. You need more of a character, Hammy.
She needs a personality. Because she had, like, one defining trait, and then this episode just took it and turned it on its head and went, no, she doesn't.
Yeah, like...
And now who are you, Hammy?
I don't know.
Who are you, Hammy? I don't know who you are anymore, Hammy.
It's like we don't even know you anymore.
Good, I'm glad you're coming with me on that one.
She's still adorable, though.
She's still so cute. Kawaii?
Yes. That is what Hammy exists to be right now.
Hammy is the epitome of kawaii.
Yes. They just need to figure out what to do with her.
But then again,
that.
She's not the only one who's kawaii. Because Raptor is, too.
Yes. Raptor is still on point. Raptor had no connection to the plot, but they used her character to still make her a presence in the story.
Why does the android have the most developed personality of anyone in the show?
I don't know. Like
a lot of the other ones can boil down to one trait.
Yeah.
But Raptor actually has depth.
Like, it's
not very much depth,
it's
but
just,
more depth than anyone else.
Every now and again, you just find a character where you just latch onto the voice and it's golden every time. Like with Coda and Ivan in Dino Charge.
They were so good together.
They were good separately, they were good together. Whenever you put them into the scene, you knew exactly what their voice was, and their reactions to the situation would always be great. That's working with Raptor right now, and with Naga as well. With Naga, all they need to do is just make sure that whatever he's saying, it does not match the emotion he's showing, and it'll make it better.
And I wonder how much of that is up to the actor. Obviously, they tell him what he says.
Yeah.
And they tell him that he needs to be incongruous.
Yeah.
But the question is he picking which incongruous emotion he's displaying, or are they putting that in the script?
I don't know!
I'd be curious about that.
I don't know. Anyway, I think we probably picked this episode apart enough.
Yeah, this is gonna be a short one. Okay.
Yeah.
So, yeah, there's just not much... It's boring episode. Sorry.
Still found a good amount
but
to talk
you just
about.
Had, like, a whole week of videos, so you should be fine.
Yeah, and this
we'll
is,
see you again on Wednesday.
We didn't really cut it off that short or anything. This is still pretty...
No, it's actually... let's put it this way. This one was actually reasonable. We usually
yeah, we didn't run long this time.
So...
We still found plenty to talk about.
We did.
Mostly with regards to how to balance the characters moving forward. Hopefully that's what they end up doing.
Yeah.
Fingers
crossed.
I mean,
they've got plenty of time because they use, like, a 50-episode thing, so...
Yep.
So you guys still have time to recover. Not that anyone from the Sentai is watching us!
Yep. I certainly hope not. They'd probably take us down. Because they do not... They would not understand what we're saying and would probably not appreciate it.
Yeah, but, I don't think they could take us down for talking about it. We
don't
show it and we turn the volume down.
That's a good point.
So
my big hope for next week is that X-Aid is not a Mr. Pega. But people have told me that X-Aid is really good, so Let's hope that. Let's hope he works with the Key Ranger World. So, until next time, farewell, Ranger fans, and let the power protect you.
I'm just so happy.